What's up, everybody? Well, today's day 220, making Songbringer, and today I'm going to be working on a mini boss. I've already got him pretty much started. It's triggered via the story system, so it kind of happens in a special way. Normally, you would encounter... Sorry about that. Normally, you would encounter some enemies according to exactly where they are on the overworld. So, for example, these enemies are placed here. Before the world is ever even played, as the world is being created, it decides that I'm gonna put an area right here where there's one of these big blobs and three of these small blobs. But this is a different thing. This guy here is the mini boss. He's placed via the story system, so the story system triggers him to place, triggers the world or the area to place an enemy. If it's your fourth screen you've been on and you have the sword. So that way, basically you can always find this first mini boss after, you know, on your fourth screen. So it doesn't really matter. You've had a chance to basically be on the home screen to go get the sword, and then one more screen so you can actually try out fighting a few enemies, and then this screen to fight the mini boss where you find your first item. So I think this is going to be a lot more rewarding as a player to fight this mini-boss right on. It's kind of exciting, and then you get an item right away, too. So it kind of shows you that there's items in this game faster. So, yeah, all this came about from watching my friend play, and I was like, you know what? I need to really show the player that there are items before they get too far into the overworld or the level. So that's what's going on today. I'm going to be fixing him up and making him even better. What I want to do first is to make some, like, to draw some spikes or something like that come up and block the rest of the screen from being... What up, Nano? How you doing today, man? Yeah, so I'll start with that. I guess it'll look kind of like a tree. Hey, what's up, Coin? Hey, guys. Needs to throw sharks at you with laser eyes? All right. Where am I? Oh, here it is. All right. Graphics time. Draw some little spikes that come up. That's the first thing. So the second thing I want to do is to make it so he throws stuff at you. So you're going to be acquiring the homing drones item from this mini boss. So the goal is to get him to use the homing drones to attack you. So basically he's going to kind of throw something kind of like a top hat or a boomerang, something like that, that you, once you kill him, you acquire that item. Needs more cowbell. Definitely needs more music, you're right. Alright, I want these to be perhaps... I think I got this. Maybe three tiles, two tiles high. 24, 20. Yeah, I guess 24 will be the height. Width 20. All right, let's draw some base. Base, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, so I think it's going to be sort of like a spiky thing. Maybe not quite this entire width. Such a good artist. Look at this. This is beautiful. All right. So yeah, what I'm drawing here is some spikes that are going to appear around the screen to like lock you into this screen where you're fighting this mini boss. Okay, so that looks super 2D. Let's make this a little more 3D. Nice, the bad joke. Awesome, man. All right, I'll add that to the ideas list. The bad joke idea. That could be a really fun Easter egg type item. I like that. Are you not entertained? It was such a bad joke. Such a good bad joke. It's starting to look a little better. What's up, Arcane? Nice. Nice. Okay, so that's good enough to try out a quick animation with this guy. Common. What up, Turdicus Burgicus? Why do I stand up? Better for my neck. It does kind of look like an acorn, right? Just hope it doesn't look too much like an acorn in the game. Butterfly? No. This is wood spike. Okay, now let's animate it. Coming out of the ground. So. Turn off that evil propagate one. All right, now let's put it down on the ground. What's up with this? Oh, there we go. So, imagine some dirt flying. Yeah. Nice. I hope it doesn't look too much like an acorn in the, when we put it in the game. We'll see. All right, so it'll look something like this. Yeah, it definitely needs some of this, some of that. A little bit better. All right. Okay, so we can render this thing, put it in. What up, Pete and Wally? Welcome, welcome, welcome. Here's what I'm working on today. Working on a mini boss. This mini boss appears on your fourth screen if you have the sword. So you go, you start off here, you go down and get the sword, you come back up, you go to one single area, like perhaps to the right or whatever, and then your fourth screen that you visit has this mini boss. So you can't actually walk off the screen here, so you have to fight him. And now I'm creating these wooden spikes so they come up when on the edges of the screen so that it looks like, you know, you can't get off the screen, and kind of explains the fact that you're stuck here for a second. So yeah, after you beat this guy, this is where you first get the homing drones, which you allow you to throw your top at. So that's what I'm working on today. I'm gonna make it so these wood spikes come up. And then also make it so this mini boss guy has some sort of boomerang style attack. So it explains the fact that you're acquiring that ability from him. Yeah. And I think it's going to make the game a lot more fun for, especially for the play, for players that are, you know, just brand new to this game. You don't really understand much about it. You get this sword, you have one screen to go fight a few easy enemies, and then all of a sudden you're thrown into sort of this intense battle, and you win a nice reward too. So you get this awesome item. So I watched my friend play, and I realized that basically the game kind of needed this. It needed some more exciting and also intriguing elements really quick in the game, because getting this item intrigues you and goes, oh, look at all the items I might have in this game. Uh-huh. Okay, so now we've got this wooden spike thing. Let's create a profile for it. Or not. I guess I don't really need them. So I'm trying to think of how the best way to do this. I guess I could actually do it here in the lock exits method. We could go through. Create. Oh, we kind of need to create a separate entity for each one of these spikes. Yeah, okay, let's just start doing it the janky way. So we'll loop over every single one of... Yeah, actually this should be an area method. I think. I'm going to do it as a function of area for now. I'm not sure if this is exactly the best place to put this, but for now, Oh. I saw that game. It does look really scary. Okay, so we'll loop over all. All the possible tiles. Okay, so if the current if the current entity or if the current position, this tile position or whatever, has a collision component, then we'll put an exit spike here. Not myself, no, not really. I'm not really a fan of horror games or horror movies, really. They scare me too much. Yeah. Oh, there you go. Oh no. Yeah, in general, I prefer the old school 2D games that aren't so horror. But if it's a 2D game, I might play it if even if it's horror, because I like 2D games so much. So this would be a save. We're gonna go collision system. Get collision for id nothing. Mask K filter exit position. Let's make this a V3F. Oh no. Yeah, the alpha's coming out as soon as, what's up, Speedy Flips? As soon as I can get it done. The intention of mine is to get it done before the end of the month. I hope I make that date. We'll see. It might be the first week of October, if not, but hopefully I get it out this last week of September. Oh yeah. Yeah, that one. Yeah. Thanks, Speedy Flip. So let's do a size of. Probably tile size. Okay, so if sid equals 0, we'll continue this loop. Otherwise, we know we have a place that's has an exit where we should put a spike. So let's create an entity. New position component. Render component. So that's, we got profile parent Z. We need a new collision component here. What up, blood? Howdy, howdy, man. How's it going today? Category, mass, size, damage. Always have to look these up. Category. Mask. Size. Size is, should be 3D. Yeah, it's 3D. So let's make this 3D size thing. There we go. Size, damage, parent. Nice, right on. So let me show you what I'm working on. I'm working on this this mini boss. So this guy is something you fight on the overworld, and it's story driven too. So he always appears on the fourth screen that you happen to come across. So if this is my fourth screen, then boom, it's got this mini boss. I can't leave this screen. So right now I'm working on some spikes, which will kind of like trap you onto the screen while he's here. And you get the top hat from this guy, or the homing drones, which allow you to throw your top hat. So that's the goal for today. Put some spikes here on the edges, and then also get this mini boss guy to have some kind of boomerang attack. What up, Big Mac Dev? How much longer is pre-order going to be open? All the way up till release, which is so... Basically, through December, you'll be able to pre-order it. What's up, Xbox Taco? Professional Novice, what's up, guys? Okay. So we've got a collision component. We might have an animation. Let's see if this works. Oh, we need to put this in the system for when it calls these. Here's where it creates a foe. We only want to lock these exits too if we have an item which allows you to open the doors afterwards. So, all right, so we'll go area, exit spikes, adding them, true. We're not really going to get rid of them so yet, just so. Thanks, Big Mac. All right, man. Thanks for joining. Hope you have a good cooking session. What up, PETA? Welcome, man. Welcome, welcome, welcome. I'm working on the first mini boss for the game. You actually encounter this guy on the overworld. So, first you get the sword, fight a few enemies, and then boom, this guy just suddenly appears on your path and gives you your first item after you defeat him. What up, Thomas? All right, so we're locked in here. Okay, so that it didn't work to create some exit spikes. I wonder why. Let's see. So let's get in here to this exit spikes function. See what happens. What up, what up? Right, cool. Step in. Oh, okay. This, we need to do a little bit smarter. So in the system, before we lock all the exits, which actually essentially turns the exits into a different filter category, we gotta do that. What up, Proton Gaming? Thanks, man. Yeah, there's a different boss. Yeah, there's another big boss with a giant maul, and he's really tall. This is more of a mini boss. He's a lot smaller, and he just gives you this one item here on the overworld. He's a lot easier than the first boss. So, yeah, he's just meant to kind of excite you as a player and give you an item sooner on in the game. Okay, cool. We got some spikes appearing on the bottom row. But they just keep going up and up and up. I don't wonder why there's nothing on the top on the right row though. That's weird. You know what? I guess there's a way easier way to do this. Instead of trying to collide with exit components, we can just do this a lot easier by doing. All right, so if X. Greater than zero, and x is less than width minus one. Continue. So we're only going to do the edge tiles. And then, same thing with y. What up, PMC? Welcome to the stream, man. Working on this mini boss guy. He's going pretty good so far. Okay, so yeah, we're excluding everything but the edges. And now all we gotta do is just detect if there's a tile at the current point. So if there's no tile, then we continue as well. Right, so now we don't need to worry about this whole detecting if it's a like that. Cool. All right, that should basically do it. Alright, let's see if we got them out now on the. Oh man. Now they're not appearing at all. Son of a. Okay. Right, well, I'll set a breakpoint. Figure out what's going on. Just gotta be simple. Yeah, so at x, y, 0. Sorry, I wrote this logic wrong. So basically, if it's You can be a part of this whole thing if x is 0 or x is width minus 1 or y is 0 or y is height minus 1. Okay, so come on, spikes. I want to see some spikes coming up out of the ground on all the edges. Okay, Okay, come on, come on. Yes, all right, we've got spikes. That was kind of weird. We got, oh, because it has a collision component. It kind of blocks you at the beginning. Okay, we definitely got to get these things to stop popping up. And it'd be nice to give them some shadow components too. That would look good. Okay, so now we're gonna need a render, like an actual profile for these things. So we can have an animation for when they come up, animation for when they go down, all that. Nice, right on. Right on, man. First step, first step. Have you, well, not first step, but like, yeah. Yeah, dude, nice, man. Nice. That's rad. I'm sure you're on the path to having a juicier game. Juice is so important. Top hat. This is a good one to start with. Okay, so we'll make a wood spike profile. This wood spike's gonna have an idle animation. It's just wood spike. The final frame. The final frame. Thanks, professional novice. Cheers, man. Well, it's because I got a good system written here with this whole game. Making it data-driven, using entity components. That's just really enabled me to work really fast with this game. And also, I know my code pretty well, so that helps too. And I'm very familiar with my game engine. I've used CocoStudiX for many years, so I understand that pretty well. So yeah, there's a lot of things. There you go. All you need are those kind of things, and you can make your own games really, really fast too. I just want to see how many frames that. Oh yeah, we just look at this. 7 frames. Okay, so this wood spike 6 is going to be the idle frame. That's where it stops moving. This is where it comes out of the ground. I don't know what to call this. What is that called? Emerge, I guess. Call this one emerge. It's definitely not gonna be, that was a little bit too slow with the whole point one. So we'll do emerge, wood spike, this. Okay, and then release is gonna be when it dies, or I guess we just call it submerge in this case. But release kind of keeps the convention. So same exact format, but we reverse this thing. Doesn't have any sounds yet. That's right. I guess I am a pro, right? Okay, so yeah, now we're here in this render component thing. We can go and create it with the profile wood spike and immediately play the animation for emerging. I would think. So we play emerge once, and then afterwards we play idle forever. There, so that hopefully should make them so they come out of the ground and they stay out of the ground instead of just coming up and up and up and up. Oh, and also these don't really need collision components. Yeah, they don't really need collision components at all. Thanks. Okay, what's this? What? OBS could quit? Still going? You guys see that? And it still works? This is voodoo. Okay, I'm gonna leave it then. We'll just leave all this message here in the background. As long as this stream's still going. Yeah, okay, I'm keeping it. I'm keeping it on. Maybe, maybe. Let's just hope it, let's see what happens. I don't know if this stream is now like in jeopardy. It's the Jeopardy stream. Da na 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 na. Here we go. Cool. We got some spikes, but they came up right away. They'd already been up the whole time. Wonder why. Pick up this item. All right, now we gotta trigger all the items to disappear, these guys. Yeah, definitely. Blast the chat if it does go down. You might win. Okay, so if we wanna not add or just remove. Okay, so we'll just loop over all every entity, I guess, with the render component. Yeah, we'll use a render component for this. Yeah, okay, so for oh man, I just suddenly realized something. Maybe this is why it's not doing. It can't run animations without a profile component. Duh. So wood spike. Maybe that's why it didn't do the initial animation. Yeah, Thomas, for sure. It does need to be much more prevalent. Yeah, Jib saying something would be a good thing. I was thinking of first of also making it much brighter, so like it'll have much like more like bright thing. But that's a good idea to have Jib say something. I like that. Let's start on the process to removing these spikes too. There, so we can remove the spikes. Yeah, yeah. What up, Fearless Hyena? Welcome back, man. Maybe we just need to call this. So remove the exit spikes when we lock exits. Yeah, I guess we'll do this in system, lock exits. Here it is. Lock exits, and we'll want to add and remove spikes here. That'd be cool, Sage. That's crazy. This has been requested so many times. People have been like, "Hey, you should put yourself in the game somewhere as an Easter egg." So yeah, it's already on the ideas list. So yeah, I'll have to do that. Nice, right on, PMC. Cool, good for you. As soon as you start making them, definitely share. I'd love to see them. Oh. Yeah, totally. Or a boss. It's my head. There. Now I've got this tied into the lock exits method. Yeah. The final boss is me. What game? There's a game that did that recently. All right, that time the spikes were still there, all the way up. Okay, at least that time they disappeared. But we want them to actually go into the ground this time. Oh no, another bot? What's up, bot? Hey, I'm about to ban you, so if you're an actual person, you better say something soon, because I'm like, oh, I got a twitchy ban user finger. Oh my god, oh, I almost pressed it. Oh! Do I think I'll be able to make a real person in pixel art character? Sure, yeah, man. Of course. Yeah, totally. This guy sounds like a bot for sure. Definitely not clicking your link, bot. You got like 30 seconds to prove you're human. B-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b-b- Okay, we got this thing we want to do. Yeah, so we need to make this a little more sophisticated. It needs to run its exit animation. Banhammer, ba-bam. Like Einhammer? Oh, it was one of my favorite games on PlayStation 2. Einhammer. Banhammer. Oh, you pressed a link? Oh no! Was it actually a link to that game? Oh, this is the thing at Burning Man? I thought Einhammer was a game for PlayStation. Am I wrong? What's it called? No, that's not it, huh? What was that game? Oh man, it was such a great game. I can't remember the name. Oh, Einhander. Einhander. Yeah, I love this game. This is such a sweet side-scrolling shoot 'em up thingy game. Loved it. Loved it. Did it? Okay, this guy's banned, dude. You're a bot. See you, bot. Okay, so this time we're going to, instead of just delete the entity right away, we're going to run its It's a release animation. And then we'll set a timer, schedule once on this thing. Render dot sprite dot schedule once. Schedule it. Ah. But they either do or somebody they hired does. Or I don't know. Maybe somebody's just promoting it for the hell of it. Oh, the wrong schedule once. Schedule once. Oh no, that's right. Never mind. Okay, so we're gonna want to delete this entity. After say a second or so. Let's try that. And then we also need to get them to actually appear correctly too. The submerge animation isn't working. Wonder why. We have the wood spike profile. It should be able to play this emerge. And then we need to draw these a little bit better. I think their spikes are a little bit too wide. He's quick. They went backwards. Or maybe they just didn't reverse right. I could have sworn there was a reverse keyword. I'm pretty sure there is. Reverse. How does that work again? Reverse. Oh, maybe I have to put a 1 after it or something. Reverse. Foundation. Oh no, it's here in profile. Oh yeah, I gotta put a 1 after this thing. Oh yeah, there you go. Yep. So it's not G2A themselves. It's this guy, whoever he is. Just trying to make his living in college or something. Trying to pay for those books. Alright, so this wood spike thing right here, we need reverse 1. And it also need to stay down. And let's see what we can do to figure out why this entity isn't animating its emerge either. So for example, what if we just went K forever there? Socially reinforced illusion? How so? How so? Help me get the joke. Oh yeah, so there. They work if I do forever. So maybe they've already run or something. Aha, okay, cool. That's nice, all right. Did I go to college? Yes, I did. I did for a little while, about a year and a half. I did not finish my university education. I'm not sure if you would call it a university. It's Oregon Institute of Technology. It was an institute. The institute I went to, I did not finish my schooling there. I'm glad I didn't. Yep. But I also I kind of wish I would have went to a cooler school with more girls. That's basically why I left my school. I was like, dude, there's no girls here. I've already been making video games. Why do I need to go to school to learn more about their general software development? Yeah, thanks, man. So, and I don't know, I've always been this person that's always already known what I wanted to do with my life. I've always wanted to make video games, so why go to school when they don't even teach that at the school that I went to, you know? They just taught about how to be a good worker at some software firm. You got your 2 year? Yeah. Exactly. Yeah, my whole school was a total sausage fest. It was fun, you know. I learned a lot of cool collegey things, like how to drink, that kind of stuff, you know. But yeah, what the heck am I doing here? Oh yeah, I want to make this animation 7 frames long, and the first frame to be blank. You can, yeah. That's why I'm always encouraging people to learn on their own and trying to help people learn how to do game development, because you truly can. You can learn an entire industry, whatever it is. It doesn't even have to be making games. You can learn how to make music or bots. Like, you can make robots, whatever you want to make. You can learn it on your own. Yes, exactly. Professional novice. Yes. If you're not building your own dream, you're building somebody else's. That's a pretty good saying right there. Yeah, true. Yeah, exactly. If you're not interested really in what you're doing, you're not going to learn it. It takes some of you. I get you on when you're saying that. There we go. Now it's got 8 frames. Render video wood spike. Yes, of course. Nice. Dude, that was fast. Right on. Yeah, totally. Yeah, me neither. Me neither. Yeah. The closest thing we had to learning in my day was books, you know? But now we've got YouTube. YouTube, you can learn just about anything. And it really is awesome. What's up, baby? Yeah, he'll post. Yeah. Oh yeah, we don't even need to specify the number of frames, that's right. But here we do want to do wood spike 7 or whatever. Okay, so I guess the way to do this is to trigger them to open up. Yeah, I'm gonna do this all in 3 functions, not just one. This is kind of janky. So, we're gonna have add exit spikes, remove exit spikes. Oh, you know what? We don't really need the whole add or the remove exit spikes. Yeah, we don't need add to be a separate from show. We just need to show the exit spikes. I guess we would need a method in Flux to determine whether to show the exit spikes. So, yeah, I guess we'll do a function of system, exit system. We got lock exits, and let's do a bool or exits locked. There, with these methods. I have not yet, but I've been told that I should. It doesn't look that hard, but I don't you have to have a is it do you have to have a finished game for that one, or is that itch? When is the next Ludum Dare? Is that how long is that? 3 months away or something? It 6 months. Cool. We got these methods. Area. Now we're gonna have add exit spikes. Remove exit spikes. Oh. Backwards. Right, Fearless Hyena. December. Ah. Oh, cool. It's my birthday. The race to finish Songbringer before, yeah. It is quite a race. Before my Kickstarter funds run out, really, is more like it. Remove. Oh, man. I built these wrong. Oh, yeah. Go ahead, time it however you want, really. Right, and the exit system needs a Boolean. Exit system. Our exit's locked. Nice, right on. Oh, thanks, man. Yeah, I got some. I just haven't put them up yet. I used to have them on my boat. I used to live on a boat, and it was really awesome. I had two big 85 watt solar panels that would power basically my laptop and a little bit of power for lights and things like that. And yeah, I lived that way for 3 years. So I still got those same solar panels sitting down in storage. I just haven't put them, because now we live in an actual house or whatever. So I haven't, just haven't put them up yet. Yeah, my Yatchit. Yeah, totally. Ludum Dare is a great way to get yourself into the scene, because you get to meet people too. You know, like you can start a Ludum Dare pro. You can do a game jam with anyone though at any time. You don't have to wait for Ludum Dare, but Ludum Dare tends to be one of those things where you do happen to meet people, because there's so many people that are interested in doing the Ludum Dare, and yeah. It's just a great time to either meet artists or programmers or whatever. Okay, so here's how it's gonna go. When we lock the exits, oh, we already got this. Ah, lock exit. Google World area dot remove exit spikes if there are any. Yeah. Sure, why not? Hell, that's a good idea. You guys could even start your own game jam. That's a stream showing game development while viewers do game development. Nice. I like that a lot. Now all we do need to do is add the exit spikes. And I want to do that after we do flux. When flux slide ends, so slide end, disable exit components. Add exit spikes. If exit system is our exit locked world area, add exit spikes. Here's crossing my fingers. Hope this works. Yeah, nice. Telling you, there's a lot of people that watch this stream. So if you really did want to organize a game jam or whatever, I'm pretty sure that would be possible. Sorry, I wouldn't be able to actually participate myself. All right, yeah, I think it's working. I just forgot to do the whole making it so when it creates these spikes, it only does this emerge once. Okay. Come on. Oh, nice. Oh, yeah. All right. We finally got some spikes to come up. And they stay up. Yeah. Awesome. Now it's time to make this look better. Yeah, you could. You could. You definitely could. That thing's on all the time. Sometimes I get on there and I'm like, people are chatting already. I'm like, what? You guys are already here? Yeah, okay. Time to make this art better because this is kind of weak sauce. So they're a bit too wide. Start by making them slimmer. That is 4 pixels on the right or left. 4 pixels on the left. Sweet. Who's Nate? Yay! What's up, Pierre? I've told you this before, Vlad, but I'm really growing to like this guy. He's such a lovable character. Oh no, there's a knife! Ooh. That knife looks really sharp. Yeah! Nice screen shake! Let's see that again. Yeah, man. Nice. Yeah, cool, man. More. I want more juice. More particles. Where is that talk? Did you see that talk by the guys at, Whoa. Nice job. Nice job, Blood. Yeah, the beard. That's right. What's that talk by the guys that made Nuclear Throne? Now here it is, The Art of the Screen Shake. Yeah, totally. If you haven't seen this video, anybody who's making games, this is a freaking, this is like game development 101 type stuff. You gotta understand all this stuff. But Flood, particularly for you, I'm posting this right here. If you haven't seen this video already, Knife Beats Business. But yeah, that video talks a lot about all the types of things you can do to make your game more juicy, make it more fun, make you feeling better. Yeah. Hey, Glof, what's up, man? Yes, that's the guy that did Vlambeer. Yes. Yeah, check out this video. Amazing. Another one. I got another one for you, too. This is another one of these things like Game Development 101. But it's also on the same kind of thing. It's all about juicing up your game. I think it's called Juice Up Your Game or something. Juice It or Lose It. Here it is. Yeah, here's a nut. This is a really, really good one, too. Yeah, you gotta see this video. This might be the short version. Here's another one. Yeah, it's Juice It or Lose It. I think there's a longer version of this Juice It or Lose It type talk, though. I think this is the short version. This might be it here, GDC Vault. Yeah, I think this is it. This is the long version. Yeah. Yeah, another, it's along the same lines as that talk from the guy from Vlambeer, but kind of its own unique thing, so it's definitely worth watching as well. Oops, not safe for web. We want to go export, render video. Yeah, you're welcome. You're welcome. You're welcome. Yeah, definitely super important things. It's not just important. It's something that creates, it makes your game 10 times better just to do those little things, you know? Adding some screen shake, particles, making characters look more character-y. That's all there is to it. More character-y. Okay, cool. This is looking better. Now let's make him look a little bit more round. Yeah! That's awesome, man. That's awesome. Me too, right? I get homework from you guys too. I'm like, I gotta check out these other links and stuff. I like my homework. Oh, I know, Ekloff. Yeah, I know. It's coming out soon. Probably right before the end of the month or possibly the first week of October if I can't finish all this, but I got a lot of things left on my list that are high importance things that I'd really like to have done before the alpha's out, but I'm not sure if I'm going to make it through this whole list. I might do like half this list or whatever. But it's coming out soon, Nick Love. Did you get, Ekloff, did you get an email from me about what name you want on the alpha and all that? You should have got an email from me. If you haven't got an email from me, definitely let me know. Oh, that's cool. Yeah. Adjusting desks? Totally. Whoa. Oh, is it one of those ones you push a button? Those look pretty cool. They also look expensive. What's up, Lifeless Vagabond? You don't think so? Okay. So if you didn't get an email from me, you should email me so that I can check on your email address and all that. So just email me at nat@wizardfood.com. This goes for anyone who has not gotten an email already from me and you have pre-ordered. Because in my mind, I've emailed everyone. I've sent out all these emails and everything's all good. So if you haven't got an email from me, email me so I get it straight and you're on the alpha list and stuff. Lifeless Vagabond, I've been trying to learn Unity, but it seems like the only tutorials I could find are either way too slow, oversimplified, or they're at a good pace, but they don't explain many of the important concepts, right? Especially just try to absorb all information rather than keep searching for an ideal path. Yes, yeah, no, really. That is actually what I would recommend doing. Absorb the information. Remember to relax. That's the key to absorbing information is relaxing your mind. So the thing is this. Go do the tutorial to the best of your ability, right? Even if it's too slow or oversimplified, do those things anyway, unless it just bugs you, it's like too simple or whatever. But yeah, just do the tutorials that you kind of resonate with, like you're attracted to. And then after you do the tutorial, go and watch some TV or like take a shower or go for a walk or do anything to go relax your mind and get your mind off of it. And that's when your subconscious starts taking it in. In fact, you could do this before you go to bed. Go do a Unity tutorial and then maybe go watch a little bit of TV, then go to bed or something like that. And that's the best way to absorb the information. And I know it might seem like you don't have logical control or sense over it all just yet, but you are absorbing the information, and searching for the ideal path might not be the right way to go, because you're never going to find the ideal tutorial. So that's my recommendation. But yeah, it looks like you got some suggestions here. Nice. Yeah. Yeah, I know. I am. Wolski. You like potato? Potato's great, right? You can put it with anything. Cook up some potato and fish. All right. Oh, so these spikes, I want to move them all a little bit. Like randomly arrange them a little bit. So like plos.x plus equals this get rand 1f x y minus 0.5f times 2.0 times 4.0. Same thing with pos y. Get rand 2f. Yeah, so that'll stagger those positions a little bit. Thanks, man. Yeah. Oh yeah. Man, there's one that helped me actually when I was trying to figure out Unity. Don't know if this is it though. This definitely wasn't it. But I would definitely search around for a breakout clone. Man, this guy had this super distinct voice.
Since the last one.
Nah, this wasn't it. Man, sorry I can't find it, but there was also I did a breakout clone that tutorial that really helped me understand Unity. Too bad I can't find it, man. What up, Unreal? Okay, cool, Ekloff. Nice. I'll make sure all's good, all's well there. Yeah. Right, PMC. Cool, man. I'll check out your channel. Oh, yeah. 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 That's why I always say to follow your heart. I know it sounds like cheesy advice, but your head can sometimes lead you into corners. You know, you get stuck in these corners of like logic. You're just like figuring out logic, trying to understand things. And actually, you're at the point, Liveless Vagabond, where that helps you a lot. You really do need to go and understand a lot. But once you've absorbed the information enough and you kind of feel like you have a good understanding of it all, that's when you kind of can turn your head off and start thinking with your heart. And it'll really help to, not get stuck in logic corners. So these are staggered a little bit too much, and they need to be a little rounder looking. Hey, what up, Spymort? So I'm thinking maybe 2 pixels there, 1 pixel there. Yeah. Yeah, right on. All right, let's give this thing sort of some dirt. Dirt thing. Round out these edges a little bit. It looks more like a spike there. We can kind of darken this bit a little bit. Nah, I don't need to darken it that much, I guess. Yeah, but we do want to do that up by 1 pixel, and then on top of all this, we want to do like a little shadow around it. Yes, Code Monkey. Code Monkeys. Oh, I wish that was still on Netflix. Such a good show. Yeah. Definitely. That's a really good tip from Vlad here. Lifeless Vagabond. Is this the guy from Code Monkey? Code Monkeys? Code Monkey likes Fritos. Sorry, that was an improper key. So bad of me. Yeah, something like this. This little shadow ring will do. In fact, it should probably be something like this. We'll set it to be about 20% opaque. And make sure every one of these layers, except for the beginning one, has it. And also at 20%. Which didn't work. Oh well. We'll figure that out. Oh. Oh, it did? Oh, okay. I don't know if this is gonna look right here, but let's try it. Render, put spike. Yeah, totally. Yeah, when it comes to pixel art, yeah, I always feel like there's just a few too pixels, but a few too few pixels to be able to express whatever it is. But that's kind of the art of it all, you know, is learning how to express something with such simplicity, such just simple pixels, you know. That's what attracts me so much to it. I love how simple it is. It's like the characters in Sword and Sorcery, you know, they don't even really have eyes. Yeah, it looks a lot better with those shadows. Okay, it definitely looks really weird though with those last few. So I guess we could just move these. Yeah, well, let's just move it. That'll work. So like it'll look like that there. Here, like that, maybe. Yeah. Okay. That's better. Cool. I guess we're almost about ready to do this guy throwing something at you. Give him a boomerang type weapon and just let him go to town. I kind of need some ice water. It's a hot day. I always want to stomp on all the grass because it's so fun. All right, so we go in here. Boom. Ah, the shadows come up. It looks good. Let's watch it closely this time while as it disappears. Yeah, that's better. Cool. All right, I guess that's going to do. I'm going to go ahead and check this in as it is now. Good start to this whole day of code here. Our stream of code. Check in this wood spike asset. So I added a method called add exit spikes, which adds them all, of course. Remove exit spikes, takes them away. It adds the exit spikes if the exits are locked on phase slide. Removes them after phase item. Which technically this is a flaw here. Like if there was a boss without items, so I guess it's not really so much of an issue with this boss, but yeah. I'll need to watch that in the future. As if there's ever an enemy that's created from the story system without an item, I need to work on that. But that'll be pretty obvious when I test it. So, okay, we got a function of exit system called are exits locked. That's it. Cool. All right, next step. We want this guy to be able to throw a boomerang-like weapon. In fact, I think I'll just make it so he throws a top hat at first. One thing about the top hat, though, is that well, I guess it won't matter at first, will it? Yeah, okay. All right, how to approach making it so this drop mini boss guy can throw a top hat or a top hat slash boomerang style weapon. Throw his horns? Huh. Cool idea. I like it. Skip Zero, what's up, man? Howdy, howdy. Okay, so we need some kind of thing here where he decides in his behavior that he needs to throw his horns or whatever. So, I guess we'll do it here. I guess we'll launch. Oh, we'll launch a projectile. Yeah. Okay, launching a projectile. Duh. Okay, so the Roz guys do this. They have this thing where they launch a plasma bolt. In fact, let's just do that at first. We'll launch a plasma bolt instead of anything else. So, we'll launch a plasma bolt. Delay a little bit. Delay like. I don't know, 7.07 seconds, something like that. We want to take on the direction of the target first. There, let's see if that works. Let's just give him like a plasma bolt attack at first, and then we'll turn this into him actually using a some other kind of boomerang. Yeah, he did it. But he's going way too fast. Oh, he's so fast. You're so fast, fast guy. Speed one. Is there a speed two? Oh, here. We don't want to select speed. We want to just. This guy should be slower, a little bit slower. In fact, this whole move 65 thing is kind of a bit too much. He didn't stop, did he? He just kept going. I guess he needs to go dirt. What does the Roz do? If target any, target in a line, ran smart, ran five, dir target, animate beam, dir none. That's it. How long did it take me to get used to standing? To tell you the truth, it took about a week. It's really not that, it wasn't that bad. For the first week, I could only stand up for about an hour. You know, I was like, man, this is hard. But then after a week, it kind of got easier. And give it, 2 or 3 weeks in, and I was able to stand for pretty much the whole day. Yeah, I think for the first 3 weeks, I was able to stand for maybe 4 hours a day. And this was like 2 or 3 years ago. Right now, I still haven't even built myself back up to that same point. So I'm only standing for about 3 to 4 hours a day right now. Oh, animate? We can't have the word launch in animate. That's right. Animate. Throw or something. He stopped walking. Why, dude? Why are you? Probably because I did the anime thing. Oh, he's too slow now. Let's turn off this animate there. Yeah, skip zero. It's really important. Yeah. Keep your back good, man, for sure. Yeah, exactly. Man, just wait till you're 30. I'm only 35 and I've already started having back problems or whatever. So this is one of the reasons why I stand to work, and it's helped a ton. In fact, yeah, this was like 2 years ago or whatever. When I first started standing, this is about 2 or 3 years ago, I was having some major back problems. Every time I would go to sleep, And I would wake up in the worst pain all the time. And it was like aching back so bad. And I went to these posture correctional specialists and stuff, and none of it really helped. But I started standing up at that time, and eventually my pains went away. Was pretty awesome. Okay, I want him to have this sequence where he speeds up and slows down, just like this sequence I deleted. Wish I did. I has a present for you. What? A bot? Oh, nice. Some ASCII art? Cool, man. So this is him angry. Nice, man. Cool. So what do I do with it? What do I do with these PSD files? I'm thinking if the target is nearby, we should go speed one. If the target is far away, we speed up. Oh, nice. Right on. Cool, man. He looks awesome. Oh. Yeah, cool. He speeds up when you get farther away, and he slows down when you get close. I think this needs to be a little bit adjusted here, so. Right on. Nice, man. Cool. Maybe we'll try 111 as the bounds on that. Okay, so yeah, let's get him to actually launch a top hat or a, yeah, I guess we could have him launch a top hat. Yeah, all right, well, let's try that out. Let's see what happens if we just say top hat. I know it's not going to work, but I'm hoping it'll do something. There's just like a little top hat here. It's so funny. He's like, top hat, woo, top hat. Okay, so now, yeah, let's get him to actually launch a top hat. So right now, the area has this method to create a top hat entity. And it does all this stuff to launch it and stuff and stuff and stuff. Really, the only thing you would need to do is just create one of these and then switch this collision component. This is something I implemented myself. That is a These are behavior trees. I actually covered this in one of the videos. If you want to watch, just search for behavior trees. And and also you can research this stuff online about how to do behavior trees, but this is an implementation of behavior trees in my own style. So I kind of wrote this own this whole it's not exactly a scripting language, it's just a behavior tree. My code parses all this stuff and turns it into integers and other things so that it can run these really fast. And it creates a behavior tree for AI. So essentially, I don't have to write any code for AI at all. I shouldn't have to. There's some code I still write, but like, I shouldn't have to write any code for an AI. I should be able to create the entire AI just in this behavior tree. So data-driven AI, super great. Less code. Right? Let me hatch you. Let me hatch you. Let me hatch you. Let me add him. Let me add him. Okay, so here's where like what I'm just talking about, like, oh, I'm not gonna write any code, but this is a case where I'm actually using a mood component to do a smooth movement type thing. So I need to rethink the behavior tree and try and create some way to make these without having to do this mood, but for now, I'll just do that. So it's behavior launch. What we're going to do is hack into the behavior launch. We'll go, oh, I guess we can just go start shot. Yeah, let's hack into this. Don't do it this way at home, kids. Yeah, totally, right? Yeah, with the dictionary. Yeah. That's the very day that it all started right then with that dictionary thing. I was like, what? This isn't working. And somebody was like, hey, please make your own thing. Make your own file format. And that was the beginning of Valtry, which is now published on GitHub. Problem. Oh, it was you. That's right. Good suggestion, Unreal. Greatest suggestion ever. Take it, dude. You helped birth Valtry. That's right. You're my doula. Air. Have you seen this? Valtry. That's right, you are. You know what? We can do this. So filter type K filter shot top hat. If parent dot collision. Sweet man. Collision there. Dot category equals K filter faux. Then the category is K filter shot. Faux. And then we just do it here. Category. I believe that's all we need to do. We've hacked it into the whole start shot thing, which launches the projectile. We've just basically hacking into the whole thing and Restart shot. No, not that one. Yeah, that's fine. It gives return zero. All right, so let's hope this works. So he's going to throw a top hat, which is totally wrong. We don't want the enemy to throw top hats, but I just want to prove that this even works first. I want to see how it plays before I go and fix all the art and fix up the system so it actually works right and all that. So let's see if we can get kind of a fun battle here with this guy before we perfect the code. Yeah! Oh! You can totally hit. Oh, but he flies back to the player. Oh my god, that's so funny. Oh! This is so crazy. Cause so these mood boomerangs are tied to flying towards the player, so they really need to fly back towards their parent. Okay, so how would I do that? I guess we can go and make this a little bit smarter inside system boomerang. I know that was kind of the gentleman boss. Oh. Tea and top hats. It's a homing hat. Yeah, it is. That was impossible though to beat. But it was fun. I had fun dying there. So boomerang out is fine, but boomerang in. Yeah, or slash totally. Boomerang in, here we go. So target. Oh, target is, oh. Oh, okay. So no, we can just easily change this by setting its target. So creating a top hat, the AI's target. So if this is a filter foe, the parent, then the target equals parent ID. Well, wouldn't you know? So why do we even need the use item top hat? This is definitely the player using it. Yeah, we don't even need this whole nonsense. The target is always the parent ID. All right, so this time let's see if he doesn't kill you super fast and have homing superpowers, which was kind of fun, I must admit. All right, sweet. Yeah, cool. So now they come back to him instead. Man, they move slow though. Oh, you should not be able to spam it. Shouldn't be able to have more than one at once, that's for sure. Man, he's tough with all those things. Whoa, look at this. Oh, it's the everlasting top hat. Okay, what next? What next? What next? We should get the top hats to disappear. We should also be able to not have multiple top hats at once. I think I already checked that here. Let's try that. That's one little tiny change that'll make it so. Here, let's make this code obviously ugly. It's a super hack. Yeah, so now we'll check and see if it already has a top hat. So we should only have one at a time. And if its parent dies, it should die. What? You're supposed to not be able to do that. What? Frozen Fire, what do I think about C-sharp and Unity over other options? You know what? This is entirely an individual choice. So what do you think personally? What are your tendencies on it? Personally, I think it's a great option. It's a great engine. Unity's awesome. C-sharp is definitely the language you want to use if you're doing Unity. But other than that, it's entirely individual. It depends on what you prefer, what kind of game you want to make, what kind of game engine appeals to you. So tell me more about what your situation is. Ah, so this is looping over all AI components and looking for KFilterShop top hat, no wonder. Ah, well, if you're just getting started into stuff, I would just recommend playing with engines, you know, play with Unity. Also, you should play with the Unreal. If that's the kind of engine that appeals to you, maybe Unreal appeals to you more, maybe less. And play with them enough, do some tutorials enough to kind of understand the engine you're using. And that's my recommendation. And I also think you should check out these awesome videos from Extra Credits. I know it doesn't have anything to do with an actual game engine, but it has a lot to do with game development and game design. So I always recommend it to people who are in this phase of learning game development. So definitely check these out. Yo, P-Wall, yeah, the mini boss is going great. He's actually throwing top hats now. Oh, you've watched all these? All right. Good for you, man. Nice. All right, so this is a total hack here. So has that true? Look for all the profile components. Grab its profile component. And I'm pretty sure it's called Top Hat. Yeah. Yeah, well, like I said, see, these are all perfectly awesome choices. C sharp is a great choice. C++, personally, I think is even better of a choice, but it is, yes, it is definitely a lot less beginner friendly. So, I would say just play with it. Like I said, go play with the engines until you've settled on an engine that you think is the engine for you. And that engine will have its own type of language. So if it's Unity, keep learning C sharp. You're not going to go wrong with any language you learn. Trust me on that part. There's no possible bad language to learn. So don't worry about it, that, you know. Oh, if not Hazhat, there we go. Java, yeah, see, Java is another language you could learn. It's a great language. What up, GNC? Yeah, but I wouldn't worry so much about skipping around languages because that you're actually learning a lot through that process. And I think it's important to kind of absorb a little bit of a lot of languages too. But yeah, the point of the skipping around though is to go is to settle on something, right? The point is to, yeah, you want to settle on an engine eventually is what I'm trying to say. All right, cool. So now he's throwing the top hat only once, or only one at a time. That's cool. Now let's get it. So if he dies, the top hat dies. Where's it going? It's like, bye, I'm bailing. See ya. Except for this one. Except for this one, for sure. Lol code might be a bad one to learn too. Or the Arnold script. Yeah. Schwarzenegger script or whatever. What is that? Yeah. Is it called Arnold script? Is it really that much? I thought it was less for I thought it was less for indies, unless you're not an indie. Esoteric programming languages. Arnold C. Yeah, this Wikipedia here is awesome. Where's the most esoteric language of them all, though? It's not. There's like a really, really bad one. Yeah, Arnold C. Lol code is so good though. This is my favorite though. I love lol code so much. I actually researched all about it. Ook. Whoa. Ook, 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 ook. Oh, white space. Check that one out. That's a pretty awesome one. Yeah, you said it too. Okay, so yeah, the last thing I want to do before I close down the stream today is to make it so the hat, if it happens to, if the enemy dies, the hat dies. So let's go into the system for a boomerang. Boomerang in. If target dot AI dot is empty, or target dot health dot HP less than zero, then we are done with this top hat. We'll want to go world area. Delete entity. And return. I'm pretty sure that's it. Let's try it out. So basically, it just the mood function just determines that its parent is dead. It's like, my parent's dead. Oh no, oh, I'm dead too. It's probably not going to look that good because it's just going to disappear. But what else are you going to do? I mean, you could do a little animation, I guess, of it disappearing. Yeah, it worked, I think. Cool. Let's do it one more time just to verify. And I'm going to play around with this guy's behavior a little bit tonight. Once I get into kind of refining all of this, I'll definitely play around with his behavior. Because right now his behavior is a little bit too, he's a little bit standoffish. He just kind of runs in the back and, you know, he's not very active. Yeah, that worked. Okay, so it immediately kills the top hat, but yeah, that's all right. Sweet. All right, so that's it for today's stream. You guys, I got this done. I actually got this accomplished pretty much. I got it tonight. I've got to go in and actually make it better. So the goal for tonight is to make it so it doesn't use a janky system of creating the top hat. And this guy here needs a more fun or more unique weapon instead of throwing a top hat. He should throw his horns or throw something else, or maybe even just a bright colored drone looking projectile, something like that. One of the spikes come through the stones. Okay, all right, I'll check which one is that. I don't see one of them coming through the stones, huh? So yeah, that's it for today. Yeah, progress, exactly. So good night, you guys. I'll be back tomorrow. And same wizard time, usually 2 to 4 p.m. Pacific. This game's called Songbringer, if you didn't know. And it's a Zelda-like game. It's procedurally generated, and it's coming out in January. The bottom. It looks like there's only 3 spikes there, and they're all good. I don't know. Oh, in the middle left? I don't know. They all look okay to me. Huh. Oh, okay. Well, I'll make sure it's all good, though. Looks like I gotta wait for OBS to download an update. Upload speed? Pretty fast. Nice. Yeah, we got some pretty fast internet here in the Bay Area, and we pay for a upgraded internet, so hopefully that's what probably what makes it fast. I think I don't know what our upload speed is. It's pretty good. I mean, I'm doing 2 megs a second just for the stream. All right, looks like it's probably gonna kill it with this install and relaunch. So, cheers, you guys. See you later.